Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. For today's video, we have yet another Tony makeover. And for today's video, I thought it would be very fun to make the Caliente sisters. As you can see, I did not add Katrina or Don Lothario because, I don't know, I wanted to just make them because they're very iconic throughout the whole, you know, Sims franchise. So I thought it would be very fun to make them. And as well, as you can see, I do have the older version of the Caliente sisters because I went to my save file and I edited them there because I thought it would be better if I ever come out with other save files to just have them made over already there. But yeah, honestly, I had a lot of fun. I really love how Dina came out and Nina too, like they both came out very good. But guys, I actually don't know much about the lore of The Sims. I wish I knew a little bit more. I think I should definitely like look out on YouTube, like videos about it. Because really, I don't really know much about them. I just know that they love to party, like they love to flirt. They kind of have a weird relationship between them. Like apparently like they fight and stuff because, you know, I think they both like Don here in The Sims 4. I'm not sure, you're gonna kill me guys, but I really don't know much about it. But yeah, with my idea with this, I kind of tried my best to give them a bit of the vibes they had in The Sims 2 because I really like how they look in that game. But I don't know why I felt like they mostly like, or at least Dina, I feel like she mostly likes black colors and maybe some pinks here and there. But for Nina, I really liked the purples. You're gonna see later on. I really like how that looks on her. But I have to say that Dina's outfits, I really like all of them. She looks so good. And I know I changed the mustard hair for a more blondish, platinum type of blonde, basically, because I feel like that suits her better. And also, it goes well with her version in The Sims 2 as well, instead of being like such a bright mustardy blonde hair. But yeah, I don't know, I really like all her outfits. I feel like they're very her, if that makes sense. I really did try my best to give them the essence that they had in other games, and I don't know, I really like how she came out. I think she looks really good. She still looks similar to the original version of them in The Sims 4. Which I like, because you know, with Tony makeovers, I don't like to super duper change them up like crazy. But yeah, honestly, I like all her outfits. I feel like they're very fun, flirty, cute, if that makes sense. Kind of provocative, if that makes sense as well. And a fun thing that I did actually that you're gonna be seeing later is that if you saw Dina's party outfit, I actually gave Nina the same dress because I feel like they would like to match, because you know, they're the Caliente sisters. Even if they fight like any type of sibling and all those sorts of things, I feel like they do like coming out together, having matching outfits in different colors and just showing off that they're there, they're here. Like, it's like kind of like a statement, if that makes sense. But yeah, here I was changing, I did change the lips. I couldn't make it work. I didn't really like how it looked, so I went ahead and checked out Dina's lips so I could put the same lips on Nina. But other than that, I kept her face the same as she was originally created. And here, yeah, I love the makeup. I saw that she wore more of a out there lipstick, like more bright colors, and Dina uses more like a tan bright gloss type of thing. So if you saw I did try to do that in every of their outfits, kind of like have those pops here and there because it's how they looked in The Sims 2. I really don't know how they looked in The Sims 3. I didn't see them because, if you don't know guys, like I've always loved The Sims, but I didn't get to play on PC up until The Sims 4 basically, because before I played like The Sims 3 Pets on the PlayStation, and then I played The Sims 2 on the PlayStation, which is nothing like the PC games. So like that's why I don't really know much about the iconic Sims and the lore and all that. But yeah, like if you guys know, please comment down below, because I would love to know like their lore, their story. I love things like that. And I did look it up on the internet, but like on Google, but I couldn't find much information other than they're flirty, they both like Dawn. And that I think Dina had like a crush on Mortimer in The Sims 2, or something like that. So yeah, I really don't know much about them. But yeah, Nina's outfits, I really do like them. Here you'll see that I use the same video but in a purple color. I don't know what it was. I really like how the purple looks on Nina, so you're gonna see that color throughout a lot of her outfits actually. But yeah, she looks very cute. I really like her. The hair that they gave her, oh my god, I hate it. Like the original one, the Sims, like the base game hair is so ugly. But luckily we have better options now for hair. But yeah, I really like the also like the blush that came with high school years. I feel like it gives the illusion of them like being recently tanned, if that makes sense. So yeah, I really like that. I feel like it adds like a touch to them. I feel like it goes with them, if that makes sense. But yeah guys, I hope you like this makeover. I'm actually very happy with how it came out. Like at first I was kind of nervous since they're like such iconic Sims. I wanted to do them justice. But I think they came out pretty good. I think they both look super cute, and I don't know why. I feel like it would be very fun to play with them and just be chaotic, basically. But you're gonna see the outfits now slowed down, and I feel like they are both slaying. Like I feel like their outfits are so good. I feel like they look amazing, basically. But yeah, I was very happy with. I mean, I'm very happy with how they turned out. I hope you guys feel the same way. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this, and let me know who else should we do a makeover of. I feel like there's a lot of Sims that could use some help out there in the Sims 4. But yeah guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.